someone says they want to fight me, I'm like, I'm game.
We're going to come and we're going to roll these people.
They're overconfident.
We're banging.
I think she's better than what she is.
I don't think that anybody can beat me right now.
She's not my friend. Literally, punch her in.
I can't wait to punch her in the face.
You're going to eat your words. So I'm in the Fight House kitchen, so a bit of a mess at the minute. For this fight, I think I've been up here, must be about 16 weeks or something. I've been up here a long time. But now we've got the Fight House, it's better because I've got my own room, which is my room, so no one goes in. A bit more of a homely feel, and like my candles and everything, so it's quite cute. There's my meal prep kitchen, keeping me through camp. Everything's like calorie count as well, it's fitness pal.
Yours is the organised one at the bar.
Yeah, yeah. Theirs is just all over the place. I feel absolutely amazing. I feel like I'm living the dream, and I never thought I was going to be finally in the Undisputed camp. This is my bedroom. Gingerbread. And then there is a... I do like my candles. And it's lonely anyway, being away from home, ain't it? So to have people doing the same kind of thing, it's nice. You're all in the same boat. So now we're off to the boxing gym.
This is the first time there will be a championship fight in Abu Dhabi. That's all I really want to do with all my fights, is just go to new heights, new levels every time, and challenge myself and make history. Goal is to definitely be two-time undisputed, possibly three-time undisputed, and just really leave my mark on boxing history and on the boxing community as a whole.
Manchester's always raining as well. So I can't wait to get a bit of heat on me. I think it's quite special for being a woman boxer to box in Abu Dhabi, because that's in itself, and that's going to be making history as well. So that's quite exciting to get the opportunity to be one of the first. I think Bamla Ali was the first woman to box in Saudi Arabia, and now I'm going to be Abu Dhabi.
It was always a dream of hers, but now it's on the cusp of becoming a reality. I know she can do it. I don't think there's anyone in boxing who believes in her as much as I do, because I've been around boxing 30 years, and it's very rare that I'm as confident in a fighter as I am in Chantal Cameron.
Jamie and Nigel have literally been my saviours. If I look back, I think 5 years ago, I was literally like, I was so sick of boxing, just like annoyed, frustrated, screw boxing kind of thing. And where I'm at now is, I literally couldn't be in a better place mentally, physically, and everyone I've got around me, I've just got such good people around me. They're more to me than coaches, they're more like dads.
Jeff. Jeff. Jeff.
Keep on your toes. Oh, definitely, especially Nigel. Mountain time, he hits me. Honestly, I put a set of earrings in and I'm always thinking I'm going to lose him this session. I must have lost about 10 sets of earrings because he's always punching me in my head when I'm not looking.
No, it's just check earrings.
What?
Check earrings.
He's sparring tomorrow.
Of course.
And this one.
Wow. Wow. What's that one there?
They know my personality, and they know what's good for me, they know what's not good for me, and they're quite like me, like very laid back, down to earth, and just normal people. But if someone crossed me or done something, like Jamie a few times has like gone absolutely skits at people, and I'm just like, wow. I know he has my back.
She's a great kid. When she first came to the gym, a natural talent is quite obvious. Balance, her feet are really good, she punches really hard. You know, a lot of the time it's something you can't teach. Shan, she's got two separate sides to her. She's sort of a normal, happy-go-lucky, everyday, relaxed, chilled-out girl. And then as soon as you get in a boxing ring, she's a beast.
I don't think anybody trains as hard as I do.
Her work ethic is absolutely insane. She works harder than any fighter I've ever had. Guys, girls, she works harder than everybody.
That man is crazy. I mean...
Come back with the hook, on the pullback. There you go.
He's probably one of the very, very few people that gets me, understands me, and the things that he doesn't understand, he just kind of gives me space to do me or gives me space to kind of figure out my own thing, and he's just super supportive.
You know, once you build a trust between a fighter and a coach, the fact that she's willing to trust me and take new chances, take different paths to get to the final goal, she makes it exciting to work with. I think she puts everybody else first. You know, there's been times where she put me first. I don't even think anybody knows this, but like I lived in my gym for 2.5 years upstairs just so I can fund my son being in high school.
There was a moment in time where we had the gym in this building, but it was upstairs and he was living in his gym. You know, he had a little space carved out and had his bed in there and he had all his clothes and he was kind of freaking out about Christmas one year because he was just like, I don't have any money to like, you know, get my family gifts. And I just was like thinking, I'm gonna retire this man, you know? Just because he's always given like so much to us, and I just wanted to be able to give that back.
This sport's a hard sport as it is, and you need good people around you.
This sport is dangerous. It's even more dangerous when you don't move your head like Nigel. We sparred for 10 years. He was the perfect person to teach how to block a jab. He blocked it with his fucking nose.
And I literally love him so much. And if it weren't for them, I wouldn't be in this position I'm in now.
I definitely believe we were meant to be together. And, you know, not even as a coach fighter, but as my partner in life. That's why I proposed to her.
No, don't do it.
You ever see the ring, Danny, that I was telling you, Jez's ring?
Did he tell you one of his plans was he was going to put it in his mouth and roll it out on his tongue for you?
It's crazy, because everybody has like a plan to propose. When I got it from the jeweler, and then you get like the paperwork for how much the appraisal's for, this and that, and I'm like, I don't want this in my fucking pocket. You know what I mean? Because I'm an idiot. I end up like forgetting it at like the bar or something. I was nervous to drive with it in my car. I have no idea why.
He was like freaking out.
I was freaking out.
He was like, I thought I was going to get pulled over. I was like, for having a ring. He was like, you were staring at my pocket all night. I was like, no, I wasn't.
I'm like, I'm doing it right now. Took her to dinner here locally and then popped the question. She said yes, guys, in case you're wondering. I don't care who you are. Like, if you propose, like, you don't know if they're gonna say yes 100%, like, until you ask, right? So I'm like, wait, she says no, I'm gonna look like a jackass walking out of here by myself, you know?
You wouldn't have gave me a ride?
Or if you said no, I'd be like, Uber.
Walk home.
When there was discussions about me and McCaskill, I literally just said, look, I don't care, I just want all the belts. It doesn't matter what fight the weight is, but if all the belts are on the line, I'm happy, and I got it. So thank you to Eddie Hearn and Matrim for making that possible, because I imagine it wasn't that easy.
Well, I hope the next belt's not gonna be too heavy.
Belts.
And you already know, like, they're gonna try to have me do one of these, like, one set on one arm. That's why I train so hard, to hold the belts.
Right, exactly.
To become the undisputed champion of the world, it's like the pinnacle. When I started doing this 8 years ago, never in a million years did I dream that I'd be on the verge of being in the corner to possibly become undisputed champion. I'm so confident she can pull it off.
The Chantel fight is an old story, actually.
It goes back when I was with my first team in professional boxing.
Called out Chantel. We wanted to fight Chantel, either at 135 or 140 or something like that. This was a very long time ago.
I remember saying to my team, like, oh, let's just have this fight. Like, let's fight him. Like, I've never ducked anyone.
And I didn't have any belts yet. I guess, you know, I probably wasn't appealing, you know, to fight because I didn't have anything to offer.
I had the IBO. I was like, let's fight. But obviously my team managed me then, weren't interested in the fight.
And then I got my first belt in October of 2018. So then she came along and she wanted to fight, but
I wasn't even on her radar. She was doing her own thing. She was winning.
So we didn't respond to her fight request, but now it's kind of coming full circle.
So it's been brewing for a long time and here we are now.
Good fighter, puncher, very, very intense. Improving all the time. I don't see anything what they've got what can beat her. I've watched all the fights from the Katie Taylor fight all the way through up until her last defense.
I don't think she's dangerous. The only thing that could make this a bad fight is if she doesn't fight. She could touch and go and touch and go.
I know Chantel's got everything in her locker to tick every box which she's needed to beat someone like Jessica McGaskill.
I don't think she has as many options as she thinks she has, and her adjustments are in the ring, and I think our adjustments are in the gym. But everybody knows Jess is gonna come forward.
Of course she's gonna come. She's gonna bring a tremendous amount of pressure.
When Jessica puts that pressure on you, it's hard to think, it's hard to breathe. I don't think she's ever been hit by a true big puncher.
She punches hard, but you can only punch hard if you can hit someone.
I think we stop her. And I think that this will silence everyone, all the critics, everybody. I think this will cement Jessica in the International Boxing Hall of Fame.
I believe she can go down as one of the best women fighters ever, if not the best. She's capable. Keep building that legacy, and this is going to be the start of it for her.
I need to win undisputed, and then I can put myself in that sort of category. But I've done it the hard way. I had my managers, I've become world champion. I'm stubborn and I've got a lot of grit, and that goes back from my kickboxing and Thai boxing days, and I've been kicked in the head by a man and it hurts. I'll never show that I was hurt.
A lot of things in my past have directed me to just, you know, grit and bear it. Boxing seemed to kind of like call me, and then once I got into it, I realized how challenging it could be, but I've been through harder things. You know, I was homeless when I was a child. This is no big deal.
Just keep grafting and keep grinding, so that when I'm having hard spars or hard pad sessions, I just think it's all for the bigger picture. And when it does come to fight night, it's gonna like, it's all gonna play out how I want it to.
You know, you always have a plan when the fight starts, and sometimes things just kind of go haywire, and then you really see who the real champion is, because no matter what happens, she needs to be ready for the unexpected.
I love being the underdog. It's what motivates me and gives me that extra fire.
No, she's literally the A side. I come out first. She gets the pick of the dressing rooms. I think she's trying to steal some of my lines there.
I'm going to shock everyone because I want to literally punch her head in and be like, I'm the best in this division.
I just want Chantel to bring the best boxer that she is, the best fighter that she is, because I can't wait to punch her in the face.
So if I become undisputed, I think I'm gonna have to go buy myself a nice little cabinet.
Early stoppage. That's my prediction for the fight. And new, Jessica McGaskill.
It's gonna be a hell of a fight. It's gonna be a hard fight. Biting down on my gum shield, getting stuck in, going to war.